And over there to sell at Table K from KMPX Radio, Janet Wilson.
Thank you, Jim Scalin. Well, we do have a board to sell off here, and we had some very nice items, and they went for some very good bids. First of all, the bouquet and napkins went for a high bid of $48. We want to thank the donor, who is a friend of KQED. Then we had a certificate for Larkspur clocks, timepieces of Larkspur was the donor. We thank them for their donation. The high bid on that was $35. That ceramic shell that came from Jeannie's Jungle in Livermore, we thank them for that, went for a tie bid of $35. That means that you better stay by your phones because the confirmation department is going to call you and you can bid off on that item. That's the ceramic shell. The pre-1945 records, sounds like what we play at KMPX, went for a high bid of $21 from Wahlberg Recording Studios in San Francisco. Thank you for that donation. Thank you for bidding. And finally, the five books went for $40, a high bid, and thank you to a friend of KQED. We've got a new board here. We have some beautiful art items, and we're going to take a look at those right now, starting off with a sailboat. It's titled Sailboat Number 33, and this detailed oil painting on canvas is handsomely framed, measuring 22 by 26, executed in cool tones of blue, green, and white. It depicts a sailboat putting out to sea, or is that putting out to sea? I think putting is golf. The name of the donor is Patricia Landers, and she is the artist. The donor value is $100, and the most important part, the item number, is 1256. 1256. Oh, and the artist is from El Sobrante, California. Next, kind of a bittersweet scene, touched by the cruel fate of many baby harp seals. Artist Michael Walter conceived this tribute. The white on white of the harp seal against the snow is accented by his pleading dark eyes. This is a lithograph poster. It is signed by the artist. It measures 24 by 32, including its metal frame. And work by this artist is published by Tate Gallery. We'd like to thank the Tate Gallery of San Francisco. They are the donor, and the donor value is only $150. And remember the item number, most important thing to remember, 1967, that's 1967. And now we go to a forest scene in winter entitled A Deer, Deer, in mixed media, pen, ink, and brush on board. And the artist on this one is Lloyd Conrich, an illustrator who is a retired architect, so he does this in his spare time. The work is nicely framed in wood and measures 27 by 23. The fir trees cast blue shadows on the snow, and the deer is in the foreground in pale brown. And again, the name of the donor is Lloyd Conrich of San Francisco. We thank him for his donation. Donor value is $175, and that item number to remember is 1552. As you can see, we've turned the board around, and we next have Inspired by the Lotus, a time-honored oriental art theme. Marga Dozaboy, signed Kiki, painted Water Lily. It's an oil painting on canvas, and the water lilies are white with gold centers and green leaves on an impressionistic mauve pond. How pretty! The painting measures 23 by 29 and it's silver and gray wood frame with natural linen border. Nice addition to any house. Thank you to Marge Dosaboy from San Francisco for this painting. Donor value $85. Item number 1468. And last but not least, this really is spectacular. Spectacular photograph, that's what it says, of San Francisco by night. The photographer is Bernstein, and the color was produced by the Faulkner Color Lab. This is an original photo, one of a limited number, and has been styled a very pretty baby harp seal from the Tate Gallery, and we thank them too. Went for a high bid, actually an overbid, of $165, and I wanted to mention that we got the most bids on that item, a lot of calls on that seal. And because you were an overbidder on that item, we're going to send you a gift of thanks from KQED. The book is titled A Summer of Love, and it focuses on San Francisco in the heart of the 60s. That's why it's called The Summer of Love. Our next item from Lloyd Conrich. Winter Deer went for a high bid of $80, and then we had that pretty water lily print from Marga Dosaboy, and we thank her for that. The high bid was $56, and finally that gorgeous San Francisco photograph from Faulkner Color Lab done by Bernstein went for a high bid of $120. And now if you'll focus your attention on our new art board here, We have some delightful pictures, starting with a delightful picture of a plump goose. I like plump geese against a blue-green background. It was painted by a local artist, Barbara Edgren, and the oil painting is unframed. It measures 20 by 16 inches. It's signed in ink by the artist, and I think it would look awfully nice in somebody's kitchen. It's donated by Country Store Antiques of Moraga. The donor value is $150. The item number is 1255. That's 1255. And up next, you know every morning can be springtime in a forest if you are the high bidder on this painting. This oil over acrylic work was painted by Helen Vanderbilt, and it's entitled Early Morning Over Tam, of course, Mount Tamalpais. The picture has a painted wood frame. It measures 21 by 25 inches, and the predominant colors, as you can see, are greens and blues with a touch of cloud pink. Miss Vanderbilt is associated with the Terra Linda Art Association, and the donor is James Hong. We thank him. He's from San Rafael, and the donor value is $150 on this. Item number, most important thing to remember, 1963, 1963. And just below that, Sharon Sitlow has created a very interesting series of hand-treated photo silk screens. If you look real close, she's used chalk and pencil, and she has reworked the surface of her image and presents this subtle piece titled Shirley Six. Shirley the Sixth, right. The central figure is done in blues and browns. It huddles in a 5x5 space, floated on a brown mat, and the framed monoprint measures 17 by 15. The donor is Sharon Sitlow of San Francisco. Donor value $100. Item number 1232. That's 1232. And now we have Marin artist Jane Santucci. She gives us Susans on Silk. Her cluster of black-eyed Susans with their cheery yellow petals are presented in a 20 by 10 goldwood frame. Miss Santucci is a member of the Marin Society of Artists and the Terra Linda Art Association. It's an everlasting bouquet for the high bidder. Get those bids in. Thank you to Jane Santucci of San Anselmo for this item. And the donor value is $125. The item number is 1570. That's 1570. And finally, you can almost hear the wind howling and the waves crashing. I can hear them now when you view this oil seascape by R. Christo. The ocean and the sky are both painted in varying shades of green and blue. If you are one of those bidders, sit by your phone. The confirmation department will call you, and you can bid off on that. Next was that tiny little monoprint by Sharon Sitlow. We thank her for that donation. It went for $27, quite a bargain. And then we had the batik flowers. Remember those, the little Susan flowers by Jane Santucci, and that went for a high bid of $50. Thank you to Jane for that donation. And finally, the seascape by Christo. I'm wondering if that's the same Christo who did the running fence. We'll never know. It was donated by Artistic Interiors, and thank you for that donation. It went for a high bid of $100. And do we have some art prints for you now? Oh boy. This first one is an early 20th century artist, Maynard Dixon Oil, on canvas. It's entitled Earth Knower. I guess that's knowing the earth. It's captured in this poster framed in copper tone with acrylic. Muted tones of brown, red, black, earth, and blue reflect colors used in the design of Navajo blankets. It measures 28.5 by 19 inches. The print catches the serenity of this moving scene. It is donated by Allport and Associates Gallery of Larkspur. The donor value is only $50. And yours truly loves this one, so if you'd like to buy it for your favorite KMPX DJ, please call and bid on item number 1220. It's fantastic. This next one, the proud stature of this magnificent horse is evident here, and the sign print measures 28 by 30 and was done by artist Dr. Charles Eade. The equine portrait was done in shades of rust, red, yellow, and brown, and Dr. Eade's work, by the way, may be seen at the Art Rise Gallery in San Bruno. We thank Shirley Klapau of Art Rise Gallery of San Bruno for this donation. The donor value is $70. The item number, remember that, 1470, 1470 for the horse. And this striking oil painting, it measures 26 by 22 inches in tones of amber and brown, creates the mood of wildness and warmth in nature at sunset. You can see that, can't you? The artist has painted for many years, but has refused to exhibit up till now, so this really is a buy. Sue Slavik of Cupertino is the artist, and the donor value is $100. Remember the most important thing, the item number 1258. 1258. And we turn the board around, and we've got some things that I think you're going to like here a lot, starting out with a Java batik by Hadi Wasti, shows two Nagas. That's what those are, two Nagas, the mythical water serpents against the setting sun. It is mounted on stretchers. It's washable, and the batik measures 18 by 31 inches. The name of the donor is Miss Virginia Lewis of San Francisco. The donor value only $45. The item number 1759, 1759. We seem to either have sunset or snow scenes today. This one is a snow scene again. The house across the street provides the setting for Bay Area photographer Elizabeth Russell's Winter in the Country, kind of like a Robert Frost poem. While living in Massachusetts, she viewed this lovely subject daily, so she photographed it. The 11 by 14 color photo is in frosty tones of white, blue, and brown, and it's framed in brushed silver, and Elizabeth Russell is the donor. The donor value of San Francisco, the donor value is only $50. The item number, again, most important if you call and bid on this, is 1620-1620. And if you love New York, and if you're confused by this big city, if you're afraid of getting lost, well, it won't happen if you're the high bidder on this poster. Isn't this intricate of Lower Manhattan? It's done in black ink on a pewter background. The mounted and framed map measures 40 by 31 inches, quite large. The major buildings and bridges are all pinpointed, and inset street guide will help you find your way. The design and concept were from Diana Graham. Albert Lorenz did the illustration, and the donor is Robert Adams of San Francisco. Donor value is $160. And again, that item number, 01226. That's 1226. And this is John, I believe.
That's right. Thank you very much, sir. Janet Wilson from KMPX. That's it here from Table K. Table K will remain art for the rest of the KQED auction this evening.